Hello guys, welcome to Survive Russia. I just spent half the day here fixing up the bulldozer and so on. And yeah, I've not been on the computer for the past few days. Life is awesome, life is good. I'm basically out today testing a new, or trying out my new metal detector. It's this little guy here. It's really, really handy. But the video here is not about metal detectors. It's about how to turn your Victorinox into a real survival tool. In my opinion, for a knife to be a good survival tool, it is a great thing if a ferro rod or something like this or fire making device can go with the knife. This is why I have the cross draw here, of course. You've seen this time and time again. And what I also like is to carry my Trailmaster 2, my Victorinox Trailmaster 2 here. Or maybe it's just the Trailmaster, I'm not really sure, I don't remember. It's not really that important. Many people have asked me if I use folders. Yes, I do use folders. Sometimes I have this folder here sitting with a belt knife as well, but not today. Anyway, I'm blah blah blahing a little bit here, because what we are gonna take a look at is these little glow-in-the-dark guys here. See? This is actually a small ferro rod. Not only is it a small ferro rod, but it's a small ferro rod that actually works. So a while ago, a viewer, subscriber, possibly both, asked me in the comment section if I knew about this little device here that I just showed you, which is called a Firefly. And I couldn't boast about me knowing about the Firefly. I've never heard or seen it or anything like that. But he wrote it was awesome, and I looked it up. I indeed found it awesome, so I got myself this little package here. You see, here are larger ones and smaller ones for different sizes of Victorinox knives. And, as you can see, they are replaceable with the little toothpick. So the toothpick is now sitting in this little package here. Because I find a ferro rod a little bit more useful out here in the wilderness than a toothpick. The toothpick can be awesome though. So we stopped here to check out how they work, and we're gonna try it first on birch bark. If it's not possible to light birch bark, it's a bad tool and it's a bad day in general. So here we have our little camp over there and our beautiful tripod. But here we have some beautiful birch bark from a young birch. We can peel off some small peelings. So I will do that. And then we try and light a fire down there on the little log there. So for our first test, we have this little ball of birch peelings. And by the way, we are not super deep into the forest. I think we are not more than less than a kilometer from the road. I can actually hear my dog barking, but it doesn't matter in this area here, because just on the little trip with the pink ninja the other day, giving her the knife, there was bear tracks everywhere. Anyway, Victorinox knives, they are really, really awesome. Some of you might have heard me say that I rather have a Victorinox knife than, for example, the Spetsnaz machete, blah 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 thing there. And some of you guys say I'm crazy, and that's because we of course all know that if we are in an emergency or survival situation, we have to pound our way through the forest, we have to really chop and all sorts of things. Alright, so yeah, this is for our first test. I have noticed that with this little tool here, sometimes it's good to use the technique where you put the ferro rod on and pull. A technique that I actually do not use that often. It works relatively well with this little guy here, but we try this here first. See how it goes. As you can see, sometimes it's okay, but it came on fire anyway. Let's try with some of this rotten birch bark here, in the way I usually make fire with birch bark. Oh, take this piece down here. A nice rotten piece of birch bark. Oh, from a rotten birch anyway. Just use a knife blade here to scrape. It's a little bitter. That's
zoom in a little bit more. Looks very nice.
But let's try something different than birch bark. And I've kind of course not use materials that I do not have, but I can certainly use materials that I do have. Let's try some spruce twigs, because we are in super survival mode. We will of course take the little saw. Victorinox saws actually work, even though they are push action saws. I'm used to the pull action of Silky, of course.
So I'll try and make some scrapings and shavings and whatnot from this little piece of spruce twig here. Can be rather difficult on a round log. I'm sure you get the point of this, so after I'm done with the shavings, I will make some fine scrapings. Something like this here. You most likely not want to focus there. We can of course use a saw for making some finer powder. I often use a Silky for that actually. But on a round log here it's a little bit uncontrollable, but at least, we anyway got some. Oy. Yeah, there you see, round log. But why make it easy? Fine. We had flame, but I think I made my point here. But we can try and do it again, just for fun. It's there again, actually. It's just difficult to see in the light, I'm guessing. And there's actually flame. I hope that it can see it right there. So that's three times, no problem.
So if you can find anything that can be lit with a ferro rod, then these here, they work just as well as any ferro rod, despite their very, very tiny size. And then you might think that they would break, and they are small and tiny and fragile and so on. But I, of course, researched these things here before I got them. So I ran into the video channel, YouTube channel, on from Tortoise Gear, I think. So I watched some of the videos from Tortoise Gear. We have a little turtle logo here, so yeah, Tortoise. Yeah, I'm not English or American, so I'm allowed to butcher the name if I need to. Well, anyway, he made some drop tests with these and compared them to another regular sized ferro rod, because you can not say ordinary ferro rod, because ferro rods, they differ a lot, right? They are composite material, and different compositions have different properties and blah, 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 blah. Anyway, the one he dropped, ordinary, ferro rod, it cracked on the concrete. These here he dropped multiple times, and as he said, he actually put a lot of thought into these. So these are made of a special durable mix, and as you can see, they work well. So I think these are pretty awesome, because that changes the Victorinox knife completely, now that we actually have a ferro rod in the Victorinox knife. And it's a little bit of a glow in the dark tip at the end here. That is also pretty cool. So yeah, I would say if you carry the Swiss Army knives, there are no reasons not to get one of these. And if you don't carry a Swiss Army knife, why not? What are you waiting for? They are super awesome outdoors knives. Anyway, guys, I'm not paid to make any promotion for this or anything, but as I said, a viewer, he gave me a heads up on this, and I think they are really, really awesome, and that's why I do this video here. So guys, I hope you like this little Firefly gadget, and I hope you will like to check the links in the description and consider supporting the channel and all that good stuff. And until next time, get out of train, get it done, do something awesome. I'll continue, and see you in the next video, guys. Thank you for your time.